Basically, what we have here is the M252 81mm mortar system. It breaks down into three different components. We have the barrel, we have the bipod, and we have the base plate that actually holds the system together.
The Marines on the gun line handling the weapon are just one part of a bigger team. You also need somebody who first locates the target, the forward observer. And you need the fire direction center, that's the guys who call the shots.
When we receive the fire mission from the forward observer, the Marines on the plotting boards calculate the data, give us the range to target, and the azimuth of fire, which is like a compass direction. At that point, the fire direction center chief is going to look up the actual elevation settings for the gun.
Roger, one tank in the open.
Range 5243.
Check.
5-3.
Hey, everybody agrees.
Say again.
Yes, Gunner Center.
So it goes up to the FTC.
Now it goes up to the FTC chief, Gunner Center.
Goes over here.
What do you got?
Charge 4.
Charge 4.
Elevation 0836.
Now the FTC has the data that the gun line needs, and now he's going to give the fire command for the mission.
Deflection 3595. Charge 2. Fuse setting point dead. Elevation 1146.
And at this time, the gun line, the squad leader, is ensuring that the data is being correctly put on the gun. And when it's correctly put on the gun, he's going to read back the data to the FTC chief.
Well, now, how do they know when the mortar tube is pointed in the right direction? Well, an optical sight fixed to the mortar and a pair of aiming stakes just forward of the guns are the secret. The aiming stakes establish a couple of fixed reference points. When the gunner peeps through the sights, he's not actually seeing the target. He's seeing the aiming stakes. To get the gun ready to be aimed, they first ensure the weapon is level.
What we have here, it's a M64 A1 optic. On the sight, we have two different knobs and two level and cross levels. The level and cross level looks like your basic carpenter's level.
To make sure the mortar is level to the ground, you need to center the bubbles. The deflection knobs are used to move the barrel left or right. To change the range, you change the angle of the tube by cranking the elevation knobs.
May I look through the sight?
Yes, you may, Gunner.
Well, we're lined up with a cameraman. We could blow that camera away right now, I suppose. But we're not going to, are we?
All right, no more lollygagging around. The gun line is standing by, ready to fire. Hee-yah!
This is what we're all here to see. Want to see a little death and destruction.
Hanging up four!
Now, if you're wondering how just dropping a round in a tube makes it fire, there's a firing pin at the bottom of the barrel that detonates the charge in the mortar round to send it soaring. About 4,000 meters on the other side of this hill, our Marines have just dropped a world of hurt on the bad guys.
All right, now that motivates me.